to this dedication. It's emotional, it's great, it's wonderful, it's all those above. I am the school board president. My name is Woodrow Reese. I will master ceremonies. We have posting of colors and pledge, the U.S. flag, the Texas flag by BSD Police Department. Invocation by Dr. Shirley Bonton, Deputy Superintendent of Curriculum, Instruction, and Elementary Administration. Remarks by Judge Paul Brown and Dr. David Tishner, the Community Advisory Bond Committee co-chairs, and Ms. Barbara White has volunteered to fill in for them. They're here. Well, strike that. We'll have showing of a Dr. Thomas video. We visited with Lois this past weekend, and she was very excited. And Dr. Thomas cannot be here. You know he's retiring, and they had an open date, which was today, unfortunate, Howard's birthday and dedication day of this facility. And me and Lois kind of excused him. It was kind of hard. I don't know if I thought I saw a tear in his eye, but he really wanted to be here. He and Howard were great friends, great co-workers. They were just that close. But he can't be here, but hopefully the video that Jesse has set up, we'll be able to show it if we hurry up and get through this thing, because the sun's so bright. Dedication statements, Chief of Police, Mr. Duncan, and Director of Transportation, Mr. Izzel Brown. Remarks by Ms. Lois Trahan. And we have special, and then we have, I guess it's Phil Brooks, going to have a presentation. And a special presentation, Robert Zingerman, Chief Business Officer, Construction and Renovation Teams. Presentation of the facility, that'll be me. And acceptance of the facility, that would be Chief of Police and Mr. Brown. And then we have response by Dr. Shagwa, who's replacing Dr. Thomas right now, and later on. And then we'll have Marshall students. They got a special thing this morning. I hope they tell you what you're going to come up and do. Do you know it? They're not saying, but they will. Okay, and then we're going to have ribbon cutting, and we're going to have some fun stuff, some sirens and lights. So, without further ado, we want to welcome you here and for this dedication. I'll turn it over, and you know where your name was. If you could just come up to the mic, I won't have to be redundant and call you, but I will if I have to. So, the BISD Police Department, it's in your hands.
Please join me in the pledge to our nation's and our state's flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to the Texas, one state, under God, one and indivisible.
Show bow heads for the invocation. Father God, we just stop to reflect and to thank you for the life, the legacy, and the work of Mr. Trahan, who served unselfishly for 20 plus years. Father, we pray that you would give us the strength and the dedication to honor his memory by serving children with excellence every day. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. We like to do something corny, me and Dr. Bonton. I hope she's going to assist me. But y'all have to participate, too. It's corny, but it's fun. All right. Dr. Bonton, would your drum roll?
All right, now, you got to show some energy with this. This is for HT. This is for Howard Trahan. Give it all you got. I'm ready.
Will you lead me on?
All right, okay.
Two bits. Four bits, six bits, a dollar. All for Howard, stand up and holler. Ooh, That was pretty good. Thank y'all very much. We also have elected officials in here, and we have one person, one lady, that's always wherever we are. She is so dedicated to Beaumont. I love her. Gett Williams, would you please stand? City Council. We also have any other elected officials that are here. Would you stand, wave your hand, holler, whistle? Okay. We also have our esteemed board. I always want to say that word, esteemed board members that are here. We have Ms. Gwendolyn Ambrose. We have Witty, Mr. Tom Neal. You don't know why I call him Witty, but that's me and him joke. Is it any other board members here? A lot of them probably wanted to be here for this occasion. But we would like to really thank all of you from the bottom of my heart as a team of eight that you appreciate that we support you and you support us back in the community, because it's all about a family. We try to do all that we can. You know the bond, the $388 million. You know the renovations, You know the roofs, the buses, our police department. Don't they look good, Joe? I feel protected. And it's just so much that this district is about. I have to tell my old story, and I'm not going to stay long, but no other city in America that I know of, that you know of, or the media, because no one has ever questioned it, that has built 10 new schools. And look at the facilities that you have. Look at technology that you have. And our children learn from the teach to the tax to the star that, for some reason, they kind of pulled it back 15% of the grade because they wasn't ready either. But hopefully we'll find out something by next year. So we just have a wonderful school district. I like to brag that during Christmas, some of you get a $200 bonus. No one has turned that bonus back in yet. We have convocation that you can get up to 5% of your salary for just coming to work and teaching and doing the right thing. No other district really does that. In fact, Governor Perry came down and talked with Dr. Thompson, and then he summons him to Austin to find out, how do you do it? How do you do convocation? How do you pay these bonuses? Where are you getting the money from? Well, we're financially sound, some $44 million, Mr. Zimmerman. He's buying it somewhere. We're just a sound district, but we're blessed to have people that work together. Sometimes it don't seem like it, but we do work together for a common cause, and that is the education of our kids and to get this city beautiful, because new buildings, education, when people talk about coming to town for a job, even if it's in Port Arthur, they say, well, how's your educational system? And guess what? We're top of the line. We're top 10 in some phases of the best place to work. That was from the Houston Chronicle, I think. And we don't solicit awards, they come to us. There's also something in the making that school districts around the country are soliciting Dr. Thomas and his staff by video con to find out, how do you do this? I know one, Compton, California. They have the geographics that we kind of have here, and they want to know, how could you do it? And they're not doing it. So we had Fort Worth come down. We had Dallas come down. We have people looking at this district. We have, and I'm going to get off the soapbox, we have persons in this district out of 64 candidates made the superintendent in DeSoto. 64 around the country. 64, that says a lot. Little old Beaumont, and they chose Dr. Harris. We also, as you know, we have other candidates in the district. We have, right now, we have one that we're in negotiations with, and our own, homegrown, he knows the business, Dr. Chagwar, for the superintendent of Beaumont Independent School District, when Dr. Thomas retires. Now, without further ado, because I know y'all tired of me, we're going to go have Judge Paul Brown, the Honorable Judge Paul Brown, with remarks.
Thank you so much, President Reese, the board. I had the privilege, probably was one of the closest ones to Howard. We worked at many jobs together. That which you see, one of them in particular that I'm very proud of, was Martin Luther King School. We had to do a lot of work on that program, and everything that was accomplished, Howard was there. But I can tell you this, the most important thing in his life were these four individuals right here. Howard asked questions later. If any of those got anything, he might talk to you later, but he was gone to the point of where everything started. Another thing that I admired about him was a ministry that he and Lois had, talking to young couples, trying to get them to understand about marriage and about life. I admired him on that. I worked with him on several programs, not one, several. And the first time I met him in Houston at a school board meeting, Sonny Perkins had decided that all of us should be called Bubba. So everybody was Bubba, originated by Sonny Perkins. And during the halftime of a basketball game, Howard told me, come on, Bubba, let's go back here to get refreshments. Well, you can see I said the refreshment table too long. But he was just introducing me to what was going on at that time. Many things that people see with elected officials, they think they're easy. They're not easy. It's 50-50 any way you call it. Somebody's angry at you, somebody's happy. But today, to dedicate something to Howard Trahan, who gave 21 years of his life to this board. One of the most challenging persons we had on the board, Dr. Thomas, I said, you got to face Howard now. You got to face Howard. Howard asked the tough questions. And when you got ready for the numbers, talking about what we can do, there's the money there, I think Dr. Thomas would turn to Howard, and Howard would ask probing questions. I think a man give his life for education, he can give nothing better. I don't care what Paul Brown do or what he get involved in, I will always be a teacher at heart. And we served on a school board. I told Howard we got to ask every year for a raise for teachers, because I believe in my heart the most underpaid people in the world are the people in the classroom that work every day that people take for granted. And to all of those administrators that work with Howard, all of those friends, all those people out of Raywood, Texas, and I see one of Howard's former teachers back there from Raywood, Mr. Olin Rogers. He knew him. He was controversial at that time, but I loved him as my brother and as my friend. And today, I've done many things we miss him, because we missed that voice, a probing. He's going to tell you what was on his mind. Don't look for Howard to back up. And thanks to all of you that were part of this program for Howard Trahan. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, Judge. We also have our bond committee members. Paul Jones, would you stand or wave your hand? He's somewhere. Oh, there he is. Ms. Barbara White. And Mr., they say the, what, mayor of the parish? Mr. Raymond Ambrose. Just a short story. The Trahan family is just like my family. I don't know if my wife made it tonight, today, but they truly have been a family. We visit, and they're just some wonderful people. Howard, along with Judge Brown, mentored me because I was hard-headed when I came to the board, and I was stuck in my ways, but they kind of put a whooping on me many nights. And from that, I think I'm a better person. So thank you, Howard. Thank you, Judge. We also have in the family of the Trahans, we have a policeman. He's such a dedicated person. And I heard something, but I can't tell you what I heard. But he played by the books, and you get rewarded. But I heard some good things are going to be coming, Mr. Howard Trahan III. And the rest of the family, some of the families here, we know Chris, and we got grandbabies. We were talking about grandbabies the other day. I think she has 14. Oh, okay, I have six. I just said 14, but that's Miss Trahan there. She and my wife are very close. Okay, with that, we're going to have the Thomas video.
To the Beaumont family, I'm so sorry that I cannot be there today with you to dedicate the Howard J. Trahan Police and Transportation Complex. However, Howard is a very, very special person, not only to the Beaumont community, but to me especially, because Howard was the president of the board at the time that I got hired to become superintendent of the Beaumont Independent School District. And through the years, I know Lewis and Howard Jr. and Dane and Chris. I think you know all the heartache and tribulations Howard and I went through, especially working to get Beaumont Independent School District to the level in which we think it is now. And I think it's only fitting and proper that we name this complex after Howard. You know, Howard had a special interest in the police department simply because of the fact Peanut Howard Jr., you know, you're a policeman. Dane, the Chris, you know, your dad's always doing special things for you guys and transportation. Dane, I remember when you had a bus all to yourself going to Sally Curtis, so transportation and all of those things has a special meaning to me, knowing Howard, and so naming this complex is very fitting to do that. Gosh, I just hate that I can't be there with you all, because it goes without saying how much Howard meant to me personally, but also to the Beaumont community. Howard served as, he was instrumental in the NAACP, he was instrumental in being president of the board, he was instrumental in bringing change, good change, to the Beaumont community, and for that, we all have a dedicated appreciation or debt that we owe Howard for his efforts and for what he did to this community. And it's only that I think that this is going to be long-lasting to have this facility, this complex, named for such a great man who contributed so much to the Beaumont community and especially to the Beaumont Independent School District. Sorry I couldn't be there. Hey, but anyway, very special day and something I'm very, very proud of. Thank y'all very, very much. And to Howard, to Lewis, to Nate, to Chris, to Howard Jr., all of you, and the grandkids, grandsons as well. Your grandpa would be very, very proud, and this is a proud day that we remember such a great man for the Beaumont community. Thank y'all very much.
Good morning. Ms. Ambrose, Mr. Leo, Mr. Reese, and of course Dr. Thomas, and also the family of Mr. Trahan. I want to thank you for this opportunity to be a part of this great presentation. I did not know Mr. Trahan for a long time, probably about 3 years. And during that time, I really appreciate his leadership, but I know I've heard a lot of him, and that will carry us as we move forward, because as we move into this building, we plan to maintain the dedication and the commitment that Mr. Trahan has shown throughout his years on the school board to the BISD schools and to the BISD community. Thank you for letting us participate in this great ceremony. Good morning.
Good morning.
It's a beautiful day for a beautiful dedication for a beautiful person with a beautiful family. And we also want to let him know that our family, transportation department, from the custodians who clean the buildings, that we will take care of these buildings, to our bus drivers who make us go every day, our mechanics who make our buses go every day, and to our aides who ride the buses, along with the special staff in blue, okay, we thank Howard Trahan. Every time that there was something that was going on, he would always mention, a lot of people don't know this, don't forget about transportation. So today, we are honored to be moving in a building named after Mr. Trahan, as well as have a state-of-art facility right behind you in honor of Mr. Howard Trahan. And we thank the board, the committees, superintendents, and all that has done for everybody pertaining to transportation. Thank you for putting us with the safest place in BISD. Thank you all.
Good morning to everyone that's here. I want to give thanks to everyone and also to God for giving us this opportunity to see this day. And I'm going to just say thanks to everyone. I think Mr. Ezell said it, and I'm not going to repeat it. But I'm not really short for words, but sometimes you don't know where to put them, sometimes in the places as you're talking. But first of all, I'm going to introduce to you my family and my very close friends of Howard that they spent a lot of time with him during his ill time as well. So my oldest son is Howard Joseph Trahan III. My second son, Christopher Trahan. My youngest son is not able to be here as Dane Trahan, but in the place of him, I have Jacob Trahan. And on the stage, we also have the youngest of the Trahan clan is Howard Joseph Trahan IV. And I told him today that he was going to see his name everywhere. And he's really excited about it. I think he's speechless. And I'm going to introduce to you my family and my friends. My daughter-in-law, Whitney Trahan. My sister, Ginger Kennedy. My sister, Deborah Singleton. And this is going to be my extended family, I will say. Amy Anderson has been very close to me in my heart and as well to Howard. She was a very good friend when Howard first got sick. And she helped me out so much. I cannot ever tell you how I appreciated her. And I'm going to tell this little story quick on how I met her. Intex. Amy came. And we got to meet there, and she left a card on my desk that said, if you need help, cleaning, etc. And from that day on, Amy and I have been friends. And so I have my friends out here from Intex, who is Mr. Chalk, Kathy Roche, and Bruce Whitaker. I work with them from the, it's now Centerpoint. But anyway, that was the story I wanted to tell, because Amy and I have been friends ever since then. And I have some other extended family and friends, Eddie and Pat Bassett, my brother-in-law, Alfred Kennedy, my very good friend and family, Jody from Jefferson County. And I have more family and friends here, Maddie, Glodine, and Miss Vera. These are all neighbors. And some other friends I have, very good friend of Howard. He spent many days with Howard, Daniel Prudham, and also was his treasurer. And also his wife, Joanne, and another good friend of mine, Darla Lewis. And if I missed anybody, it's because I didn't see you. The sun is very bright. Anyway, I'm going to say just a brief, and I must not forget. Y'all all know him. Mr. Ambrose. He and Howard had many days of conversation, and I just leave the house. But anyway, again, I will say this has been a very wonderful day, and I just appreciate everything, everyone, the board, and Howard talked highly of the bus drivers, I will say that, and the bus employees, or transportation employees. And but anyway, I just want to say thanks to everyone, and I'm very proud, and our family is very proud of their father. Thank you.
This is a beautiful day, and I don't think we could have asked for a more pretty and perfect day like we have today to celebrate Howard Trahan in the center of the complex that we're opening today. And we didn't want you to leave here without a memento. We're going to have other things going on today, but there's something special from the BISD family that we want you to have. And put that in a special place for you.
Good morning. I'd like to introduce the folks that made these builds possible. That would be project managers and architects. First individual I want to introduce is Rob Clark with Architectural Alliance. He was the architect for the bus facility. Bob, you want to come on up? Grab one. The second individual is Bill Smith with Fitz and Shipman. He was responsible for the parking lot and driveway And I will tell you that with the parking lot and driveway, I gave Bill a very tight schedule. And he made the date, so we're quite thankful for that.
Architectural Alliance appreciates the project. I remember nearly 20 years ago, Mr. Trahan bringing architectural high school students who were interested in going into the profession to the office, and we interned those students all the way through college, and he has encouraged us to make sure everything we did was of the top nature and of the best technology.
Thank you, Rob. It has indeed been our pleasure to work on this project and work on the other projects that we've had the privilege to be a part of. This is about to draw down this bond issue and all that. This is one of the nicest dedications by far that I've been to. Mr. Ambrose, I don't know if you remember, but board meetings several months back, maybe 2 months back, you came up to me when you found out we were going to be the project manager for this part of the project, and you said, "You do a good job on that because Mr. Trahan is a very close friend of mine." So I just hope that we lived up to your expectations. Thank you very much.
We have a presentation if Mr. Brown and Chief Duncan will come up. What we have is a portrait of Mr. Trahan that we're going to present to both Mr. Brown and Chief Duncan. And we ask that you place that in the hallway in the front and rear entrance of the building, if you would. Thank you.
All right. We want to make sure that you see the bus washer right here on this facility. It's behind you there. Make sure you try to visit that if you can. This is the largest transportation business in Southeast Texas, right here in Beaumont Independent School District. They gas up, they oil up, they really take care of themselves pretty well. Now is that time, Mr. Brown and Mr. Duncan, y'all come forward again. I know you're tired of walking, but we got a few things here.
All right.
Chief Duncan, I get to pin you. No. This is a symbol of this facility here, that both of you will have a key. And the thing about it is, everything here will be entrusted into your care as though it's your house, your home. This is the Trahan facility. It's beautiful, gorgeous. It's just not cement. It's just not, but it's about people also. So with this key, and I will take your right hand, that, do you, almost said that like doing a password, do you swear or affirm? But we're dedicating this to you, and we trust that you will take care of it as though it was your own home, as I said before. And with that power, everything about this facility, y'all will be shared. I think you have a building there. We have the buses over there. But do you accept this key?
I do accept, and I do affirm that commitment.
Mr. Brown, get to pin you too. This is a key that is a symbol that represents the key to this facility. This is a wonderful facility. It's named after a very good friend of mine. I almost called him Dr. Trahan, Howard Trahan Jr. And I know what he felt about transportation in the police department. It's very dear to his heart. And unfortunately, he can't be here today to see this facility that we're going to unveil in the back. Because I know when Lois and Dr. Thomas, we rode around Saturday, she said, like I said, I saw a sign in the front, and I saw a sign, a little bitty sign. I said, who that's for? Lois said the same thing. And then when we drove up around the other side, Lois said, oh, my God. I mean, it is beautiful. You're going to see it after a while. Some of you, it's just beautiful. So do you take this key and trust it that you would take care not only the property, but even your employees? Because brick and mortars is one thing, but we still have to take care of our bus drivers, our workers. And I know that you can do that great job. So do you take that challenge, Mr. Brown?
Yes, sir, I do.
Okay. Congratulations, both of you.
I have some other relatives from Ames, Texas. Barbara and John Wright, these are my first cousins, and I'm glad that they made it. Y'all come on in and sit down. And I saw two other people, or one, Mr. Daigle. He sat with Howard so many days, along with he and Prudham. I think they took turns, they didn't know it, but I was able to continue to work just by people going and visit him. And there was another gentleman, I forgot your name.
Right here.
Yes.
Campbell.
What?
Campbell.
Campbell. I didn't know him, but he was there, and I felt safe, though, that somebody was always checking in on Howard. And there was somebody else I thought I saw, and I'm not sure, but like I said, I apologize if I've forgotten someone. Oh, my future daughter-in-law. She brought her class from Marshall School, Mary Lee West. These are the students from, light school students from Marshall Middle School, and they're here on a field trip today, and we really appreciate that. And this is their field trip for the year, and I really appreciate them coming out on this day to celebrate for Howard. Trahan, thank you.
Okay, now in replacing Dr. Thomas for now and later, but for now we have Dr. Shagwa.
President Reese, Board of Trustees, I've learned very well from Dr. Thomas. You always talk about your Board of Trustees, so I do want to acknowledge them. Of course, our CABC, all of these buildings and facilities, of course, would not be possible without having a board and a community who was passionate about children. And so as I stand here today to represent Dr. Thomas, it's a reminder to you, and I will remind you, that it's really all about the children. Mr. Trahan and I had a special relationship, and as I can tell, he probably had that kind of relationship with each of you. He and I were actually in Books a Million one day, and he saw something before he saw it. And he said, man, one day you're probably going to be superintendent here in the school district. And that was probably about 10 years ago. And again, when you work around, live around, hang around people who can see things that are not as though that they are going to be, you have to be completely inspired, of course, to be here today to see the type of facilities that we have. There were two other special people later on in Mr. Trahan's life that I'd like to stand, because again, these are our first line of defense in terms of bringing our children to school, which is really what it's about. So in his later days, we actually had this bus here to my left that brought him to our school board meetings or any kind of special functions that we had going on. Are those two drivers here today? Would you please stand? You see, it was extremely important to Mr. Trahan to always remember about the transportation people. And he understood that if they were happy, felt good about what they were doing, part of the system, it really made a difference in the students in terms of when they got to the campus. So on behalf of Dr. Thomas, and of which you've already heard, our cabinet members who are here today, our CABC, our Board of Trustees, our police department, our transportation department, of course, all of our staff and students, it's with great pleasure that we honor a man who's kept the focus on the students. Thank you all for being here with us today.
And would the board members that are here want to speak for 45 seconds? Tom, don't be bashful.
Good morning. I want to give a special thank you and welcome to the Trahan family, and thank them for sharing Howard Trahan with us for 21 years of public service. I think this is very apropos because we know now Howard Trahan's tie to law enforcement and safety of our children, and also to transportation, because he was a realist above all else, and he knew that without the kids getting safely to school, the day couldn't start. So this is very close to his heart, and I think he would be proud. I represent District 4, which was Mr. Trahan's district. Be big shoes to fill. I don't even try. I just try to walk beside his footprints. But I think the highest compliment I could pay is that when the times are really tough and there are big decisions for the board to make, I always ask my father, what would Howard do? And he always gives the same answer. He said he would think about the children and what was best for them and go forward. And so I try to keep that in mind, and I try to think about what Howard Trahan would do, and it usually or always keeps me on the right track. So thank you very much for allowing me this opportunity, President.
Good morning. What Gwen just said, what would Howard do, and I told Dr. Shaguar, there's no doubt he would think of those that were the least. And that's one thing that I did appreciate about Howard is that, he was, as Judge Brown said, he was firm in his convictions and stood by him. What a great facility for those that serve in the transportation, because you are deserving of it, as well as our fine police department. But what I want to say is basically directed to Howard the Fourth, and that son, what a great opportunity, the legacy that you have. That through your growing years, that you do understand the sacrifice of 21 years. That is unheard of to public service for a school district. And the role model that he has set and the standard that he has set forth for you and the other grandchildren. And I just want to thank this whole family for the time that they sacrificed, also for their dad and grandfather to serve this great community. So again, thank you.
And Ms. Laura said that she had friends in here. I want to thank my friends and family that came out. I see the biceps here, and I can't call everyone's name, but I do have to mention my church member, because I'll hear it in church if I don't call her name. That's Sister Cooper. And with that, would all the bus drivers please stand for just a moment? Be recognized. And I saw the police. They're probably doing what they do, policing. And, okay. I call my name.
So the police are at their cars? Let's do this.
Okay, and all bus drivers that are going to be moving buses, would you please get in your positions? Okay. We do have our lone city council person. You know, I sometimes you say city council man so many years, now you got to say woman or person. I don't know what to say, but Gabe Williams has a 45-second talk.
Thank you so much. Thank you. We appreciate the Trahan family so much. Mr. Reese and President of the Board, and all of Dr. Shaguar, this is what I want to say about Mr. Trahan. He understood that these buses rolled every morning with precious cargo. He understood that the first thing these children saw every morning was their bus drivers. And I appreciated the way that they would take the time to smile with these children, knowing they may be the ones to make the day, and the beginning of the day and the ending. I'm through with all of that. And I want to say BISD is the pride of Beaumont. BISD is a jewel for the city of Beaumont.
Right.
Without a good school district, your city dies.
Yes.
And I want you to know, as a council person,
For the city of Beaumont, we appreciate you. We appreciate Beaumont Independent School District. Be proud. Thank you. And if we can do anything for the district, please let us know.
Okay, we're going to have a Marshall Middle School kids to stand, and you're going to help them and help me. We're going to have something corny again, so this is corny day. But first of all, I'd like to say happy birthday, Howard Trahan Jr. And we're going to say move that bus. Come on, Marshall, you're going to lead them, and everybody else is going to jump. Move that bus.
Move that bus.
Move that bus.
Over to the ribbon cutting.
Police, can you pull the unveil the big banner? Can I get policemen over there? TSOs, I see some people right over there by the balloons. You come over here, come
on. Started to bend out. I guess I can be fine.
Three. All right, here's the real deal. Let's do this.